Below the last video, there was a question if it is possible to animate procedural clouds. This comment inspired me to create this video. Let's create a time lapse in the new V-Ray 6 together. Now, if you want to check out the final scene with animated camera and sound from this video, you can find the link to download it below this video. Anyway, let's start with setting up the daylight system. I will use the scene from our animation training. I put the link to it in the corner in case you want to check it out. Go to Create, choose Lights, and click Daylight System. What is cool about this tool, you can set up different locations, and it will automatically set up the light according to the specific place. I leave San Francisco though. Here, we can change hours. We can also set up a specific date. Okay, now let's find out what time there is a sunset with these settings. Basically, we need to find the hour when the sun will be in line with the compass. In this case, it will be around 7:30 p.m. Now, important thing to remember, as we use V-Ray, we need to change our sun to V-Ray. Click OK, so we will have V-Ray sky. Okay, now let's start interactive rendering. Here we go, all is working. Now, if we set up daylight system, it's typically to have the lighting correspond with the reality. We can assume that our apartment is in the direction of the west, so we can rotate the compass to match this. This way, we'll see the sunset from the apartment. Now, we can adjust the size of the sun, for example. Okay, the value 3 works nice. Now, when we do the time lapse, it needs to take a while so we can see the changes. I would say we can render 2 hours before and 1 hour after sunset, so 3 hours in total. Okay. Now let's set the starting time and let's adjust the render a little bit. We can start by adding the exposure layer. I will reduce the highlight burn. We can add some LUT on top of this. Let's see how they look. Okay, I like this one. We can reduce the intensity though. Okay, 0.5 looks fine. Okay, we can add the curves as well to add some contrast. We have the base done. Now we need to figure out the shooting interval. Let's use the time-lapse calculator page. So first, we need to choose what we want to calculate. Now we can type the event duration, which we've already decided. It will last 3 hours in real life. We have the most popular frame rate setup, so 24 frames per second, which means that during 1 second of the video, there is 24 frames rendered. Okay, now we need to decide how long our clip, in our case the animation, will be. Let's say we want it to be 10 seconds. And here we have our shooting interval. In real life, we'll need to take a photo each 45 seconds. And in our case, we'll render every 45 frame. As we've done our calculations, now we need to set it up in the 3D software. Now, click on this icon here to open the time configuration. To make it easy to understand, let's set it up as it works in real life. We don't have frames, we have time. Our timeline will reproduce 3 hours period, so every frame corresponds to 1 second. So set the custom frame rate, and in our case, it will be value 1. Let's do a quick calculations to check out if everything is correct. So 1 hour have 60 minutes. As 1 minute have 60 seconds, we need to multiply it by 60. So now we have 1 hour in seconds. Let's multiply it by 3, as the animation will last 3 hours. So now we have the number of the last frame we need to render. Now, to check out how many frames in total we need to render, we need to divide this value by 45, because our shooting interval is 45. So we will shoot every 45 seconds. And we've got the number 240, which is the exact number of photos we've got in our calculations. So all is good. As we said previously, this value, 10,800, is the number of the last frame we need to render. Now we can set it up in 3ds Max. So our start time is 1 and the last frame 10,800. Okay, so now we have our slider prepared to animating. The last thing we need to do is to set up rendering every 45 seconds. To do this, we need to open render setup and type the value here. Okay, great. Now it's time to animating the sun. First, we need to select the object we want to animate. In our case, it will be the sun. Then, we'll click Auto key. So we have start position and 5:28 pm. And now, we need to move the slider to the end and set it up at 8:28 pm. So 3 hours later, as we've discussed previously. If you see these red outlines around the values, it means that they have been animated. Now, turn off the Auto key option. As we move the slider, you can see the sun is moving. Easy, isn't it? Okay, now let's select the camera, as we will need to adjust one more thing. Move the slider to the last frame and turn on the Auto key. And start interactive rendering. You can see that the image is pretty dark. We need to adjust the exposure. However, if we change it, it will affect all the frames and it will be too dark on the first frame. What we need to do in this case, we need to animate the exposure value. Make sure you have exposure value type set up. Okay, and now we can adjust the exposure value. We need to decrease it. Now it looks nice. We can check how it looks on other frames. Okay, looks fine. Now we can do one more thing to make this shot even more interesting. We can animate camera. We'll add some horizontal movement to it. Move the slider to the first frame. We can move the view to the left. And now let's move slider to the end. We can set up the camera to another side. Turn off Auto key. Now let's check the preview. We can play animation here, however, as we have lots of frames here to go through, the effect is not visible. So it's faster to just move the slider. In real life, we need to use special sliders that help us to create camera movement within, for example, 3 hours, like in our case. This is a special rail that you place your camera on and can move from side to side. So for video production, a slider with a panning motor is a great way to get really nice tracking shots from one side to the other. Okay, let's go back to 3ds Max. In our case, I'd like to make the linear camera movement. To do this, we need to open Mini Curve Editor. Click here. Okay, now click on these icons to extend selected keys horizontally and vertically. Here we go, we can see the graphs. As we animated only in the y-axis, let's choose this parameter. Okay, now we can select the start and end point and make it linear. Okay, we can close the editor and check out the results. Here we go, the effect as we expected. As we have everything ready, we can set up the settings to render the preview. If you would like to know what V-Ray settings to use, watch my video on this topic, which is, by the way, the most watched video on the channel. I put the link to it in the corner. Now, it's time to set up the size of the images. We can set the size quite small, as it's only for the preview purposes. At the end, we need to set up the path where the images should be saved. The format will be JPEG. We can hide everything except of camera and sun to make the preview render quicker. One important thing to do. Typically, we could set up our timeline to 240, which is the number of renders we needed to render, and render each of these frames one by one instead of each 45 frame. However, I want to make it easier for you to understand and show you how it works in real life with the camera. Hit render button and wait for all the frames to be rendered. Let me show you what I've got after the rendering is done. Here are all my images saved. Let's preview them. Awesome, it's working great. Finally, let's animate the clouds. Okay, so let's select the sun and turn on the clouds option. First, we'll set up the clouds in the first and the final frame. We can start with a little bit of clouds. We can increase the variety value as well. I think 0.2 works the best. I would like to add circus clouds. Okay, this will be our base. We need to remember these values for later. Anyway, let's move the slider to the last frame and set it up there. We can increase the density of clouds. Maybe not too much. 0.5 will be enough. I want to add more circus clouds. Even more. We can test different variety values. I don't like this effect. I leave it as it was. However, I will definitely change the offset value to make the impression that the clouds are moving. Let's try 500. The effect is not visible enough. We can try 5000. Okay, I'm ready to animate the values. Turn on auto key and let's set the values. Offset x equals 3000 will be enough. I will leave circus amount to 0.9. Density 0.5. And variety was 0.2. Okay, now let's move the slider to the first frame and let's set the previous values. Density 0.4. Circus amount 0.5 and offset x 0. Okay, turn off the auto key option and hit the render button. Let me show you the results. It's looking good. Oh, there is some bug in some frames. It's probably because of the beta version. Anyway, it's looking good. That's pretty cool, isn't it? And this is basically it. Now, if you want to play around with this a little more, you can test different values in the cloud settings and create different scenarios. Anyway, if you want to download the final scene with animated camera and sun, click the link below this video. Also, if you're interested in this topic, you may want to check out our animation training, where we show you how to create the whole animation from start to finish. Click here to find about it more on our website. Bye-bye!